guys, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to talk about two books. They are both contemporary women's fiction. It is my favorite genre at any time of the year. You know, something about the light-hearted chick lit read has this calming effect on me. I don't know if you can hear this, but there is wind and thunder outside. I'm hoping to keep the quality at best. I'm trying at least. So the two books that I'm going to talk about are both E-Arcs from Ned Galley. So if you don't know NetGalley is a website where you can request for advanced reader's copy from publishers. They give you ebooks, and all you have to do in return is review those books for them. The two books that I'm going to talk about today is When Life Gives You Lemons by Fiona Gibson and A Year of Chasing Love by Rosie Chambers. So the first book that I'm going to talk about is When Life Gives You Lemons by Fiona Gibson. So we follow Viv in this book, who is in her 50s and she's trying to cope up with menopause. Her elder son has moved out of the home and she has a younger daughter who is much younger. She is 7-year-old and she's absolutely adoring. Viv thinks that she has this perfect family, except for, you know, the occasional annoying, irritating behavior of her husband. But then she finds out that he was cheating on her. Things happen and Viv is separated from her husband. Now she has to adjust to this new reality in her life. She is a newly single mother. So Viv struggles at first. She doesn't know how to pass each day and with dealing with menopause and then her work becoming a mundane routine. Viv feels at a pause in her life, but she comes through. She rediscovers herself. And I guess sometimes we all need that little nudge to look into our lives closely. So in a way, this book is a coming of age story. And that's the note on which this ends, that it is never too late for anyone to make a change in their life, if that change is what they truly desire. So I enjoyed this book. It was very witty and self-deprecating. You know, I had fun reading this, and the romance in this was subtle. There might have been a little bit of drag in the middle, and there were some, you know, powerful supporting characters who deserved a bit more time. But, you know, that's all forgivable when you look at the overall feeling that the book gave me. So I rated it a 4 out of 5. So the next book that I'm going to talk about is A Year of Chasing Love by Rosie Chambers. Olivia Hamilton is a divorce lawyer, but Olivia is a divorce lawyer with a difference. She tries to build a support system. She wants to make the whole divorce a less tedious process for a person. But Olivia gets the shock of her life when she is served with her own divorce papers in public. So, the cherry on the top. A recent article portrayed her as this divorce expert because she had recently crossed this 500 cases. Olivia is not really very proud about it, but now the irony is that she is the one who is getting divorced, and her rivals and competitors are all thrilled. And now her employer wants her to go on this mandatory vacation. And Olivia is basically a workaholic, so the sabbatical is hard for her to take on. She has been a workaholic for many years, and that is why she neglected her marriage, her relationships, her friendship. This sabbatical, she gets a chance to redeem herself. She gets to go around the world looking for what makes a marriage work. She does this as a favor to a friend, but this journey is a self-revelation for Olivia, and there are many beautiful locations featured in the book, and it is about traveling around the globe kind of book. So, you know, even reading the synopsis, I went into it. Okay, I don't know if you can hear the thunder again, but yeah. Anyway, reading the synopsis alone, I expected, you know, something like Eat, Pray, Love. And yeah, some parts of the book gave me that kind of a vibe. I enjoyed that. I enjoyed the different locations, especially when we are all cooped up in our home. Reading about exotic locations is always fun. But other than that, I had a few issues with the book. It was way too descriptive. Like, this is a debut novel, and you could tell because there was a lot of telling and not showing. I would have preferred the showing part. I don't know if it's intentional, but the book gets a little bit preachy because the main character is supposed to make a list of rules for relationship. I don't know, it just numbers down those rules, and with a lot of self-reflection and description, it gives that preachy tone to the book. Also, the book is about love, but the central character and her love story doesn't have enough backing. Olivia and her husband, soon-to-be ex-husband Nathan, the relationship is viewed mainly through Olivia. You know, what she remembers and how she remembers it. It sometimes felt like the longing of a person who's about to lose a relationship, because then we put the other person in this idealized notion. Nathan didn't feel real because most of his account was through Olivia. I hope I'm making sense at this point. Basically, there wasn't enough to buy or root for Nathan and Olivia's relationship. So overall, this is a quick one-time read for me. And now that everyone has enough time, you can read this book, you know, especially if you're really interested in reading about relationships and, you know, traveling around the globe, that kind of concept. I really had, you know, I had a good time reading this, even after all this. It was a quick read for me. I rated it a 3 out of 5. Those are the two contemporary women's fiction books that I read this month. It's really very warm, heartwarming, chicklety books, very light reads. I enjoyed them both. And if you want a more detailed review, you can visit my blog, bookbugworld.com. If you have read this already, let me know your thoughts. And if you have any other books that are similar to these ones, please let me know in the comments. And I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching. Bye.